Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 8th episode to add custom jQuery components on a fitness website. In the previous episode, we worked on sticky header and today we'll work on the ankle links. First of all, open your index.html and then we have to make sure we have added ID in each section like About, Why Us, Services, FAQ and so on. Then we also have to make sure that these ID are added as a link in your navigation followed by a hash key like About, Why Us, Services and so on. For this home link, we don't have home ID. So we can use this header as an ID. Now, whenever we click on these links, we have to move them towards a section. So let's add click event for them in main.js. Open your main.js. So this means add click event on anchor tag that begins with hash key. Then let's get the value of href attribute and store them in a variable called target. Then add if statement if target.length. The first thing I want to add is the prevent default method because it helps to prevent the URL being submitted. Then let's use animate method and the scroll top value. You can add 1000 over here. The value of this scroll top will be the position of this target, so we can use target.offset.top. You can refresh the site now, and if you click on the link, it seems it is working, but the only problem is it doesn't have the proper spacing. We will fix them after some time, but before that, let's add active class in navigation so that we know which link we are clicking. For that, you can use $this.addClass navActive. We also have to remove this NavActive class once we click on another link, so let's use NavActive.remove class NavActive. You can refresh the site again, and if you click on the link, you can see NavActive class has been added over here and the color is added using this CSS. So if you click on any link, you can see it is working now. Now let's work on this spacing issue. The spacing issue occurred because of the height of this header, and we have got one more problem. The height of header changes when we scroll down or up. Like at the moment the height of header is big, but if I scroll down the height of header is small. So we have to store the height of both headers using if-else condition. At the beginning, let's add empty variable. I will call it top offset. Then add scroll method and if-else statement. I will add the condition $this.scrollTop less than 1. If the value of scrollTop is less than 1, then you can see the height of header is bigger. So let's get the height of that header. So it's 139. You can add top offset equals 139. Otherwise, the height of the header gets smaller, so you can get the height of that header now. So it is 45. So over here you can say 45. Now let's deduct this height in scroll top value at the bottom. Refresh the site again, and this time if you click on the link, the spacing is fine. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on this read more and read less content. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.